works pretty quickly, this device. Cool. So we should now be live. We are a little bit early. Unfortunately, Sim, don't have a an intro song for you this time.
Oh, really? What about Simply the Best?
Oh, that's a banging. Oh, mate, we've got to do it now, haven't we? Simply the Best by Tina Turner.
I'm pleased at how quickly I came up with that as well.
Hey, that was bang on. That was exactly what
we were. Pleased and slightly concerned.
One sec, let's get the advert out of the way.
Wait, good grammar and spelling are important. But if you want to write essays that inspire...
Here we go, Sim. You're on.
Love it.
To double check that we are actually live. Sim is simply the best. I see what you did. Simply the best. Ah.
I thought you realised that when I said it.
No, man. No, you just went right over my head. Give me everything I need. Oh, we need this rock.
Yeah, we need the chorus.
We've got time. We're still a minute early.
Oh, cool. Yeah. Ramp up the atmosphere.
It's time to get things. Simply the best. Better than all the rest. Bang on time.
I'm going to have to start playing this before strategy session.
Awesome. you should do it in strategy session. So for everybody who's joining us today, don't know why that I'm using this new tool and it keeps changing my titles. I don't like it. Joined here today by Simeon Hockley, who, if you've seen the title, has had a very eventful last couple of weeks, right? And he's joined us today because he's going to share his experience. He's only been working with me and the other coaches for how long, Sim?
So I joined in July. I joined the full program July, I think. Yeah.
Cool, man. July. So what are we on now? July, August, September. So about 3 months in, right?
Yeah, about 3 months.
Good 3 months, bad 3 months.
Interesting 3 months.
Tell us more.
So in those,
hang on a minute, man, just before we kind of dive into everything, there's plenty of people hopping on and watching. So Sim's obviously a very popular guy. We're on YouTube, okay. We're on Facebook, we're on my profile, we're also in the Lifestyle Marketeer Facebook group as well. So wherever you're watching, please just drop us a comment below, let us know so we can actually see who's watching, we can actually engage with you as we kind of go through this interview, meeting, lesson with Sim live. He's going to be sharing some gold, I'm sure, with us all about what he's done and how he's done it. If you could just drop your questions, like if you have any questions for Sim as we kind of go through the process, please do drop your questions in the comments on whatever platform you're watching on. I should be able to see them on the device that we're using now. And if you are a marketeer, you're currently working with us, welcome. If you're not and you're a guest and you're wondering what's going on, who is this guy and who is Sim and how has he made $6,000 in a day? Then we're going to talk about that, right? And we're going to talk about the journey that led him to that particular result. So if you've got any questions, feel free to drop them in the comments wherever you're watching, and we'll potentially do our best to answer those should they be relevant and should they provide value to anyone else. So we're just going to dive in. Sim, please, can you give us an introduction to yourself? Who are you? Where are you?
Yeah, cool.
What are you doing here?
I'm currently in England. I'm back in the UK. I lived in China for I lived in Shenzhen, China, from January 2019 to 2020. Then I had to come back because of stuff, COVID. I actually got caught just as the so I came back end of Jan, and I actually got caught. My visa was being done for my second year of teaching. I'd signed on for a second year of teaching. The visa was being processed. Government shut down for Chinese New Year. I got out the day before they closed the border between Shenzhen and Hong Kong, booked a last minute flight, and got back to England, and effectively then lost my job, my home, my independence, all of that stuff kind of all went overnight. At that point, I'd already signed on to the Kickstarter that you guys did. And I'll get onto that in a bit. But I then kind of worked my way through the Kickstarter before joining the full course, taking the plunge, joining the full course in July. But in terms of kind of career-wise, I should have been in, at this point, I should have been still in China in my new flat. Like, I'd lived in the flat for 3 days, I think, before I had to move. All my stuff is still in China. It's now like a friend of a friend's. And overall, when I worked it out the other day, it cost me about 22 grand, something like that, in terms of flights, lost earnings, all of that stuff from that. So wow. It's been an interesting year, to say the least. So
for sure.
On the flip side of that, though, it meant that I've had time to hit the ground running with the life, you know, the lifestyle marketeer and smash it through.
Awesome, and get man.
Awesome results.
A bit more of that about that. So 3 months ago, you were booted out of China almost.
Yes. So
behind, and then what happened? So from moving back from China because of COVID, what happened then after that?
So I spent the first kind of couple of months. I spent the first couple of months working out where I was going, what I was doing after I got back from China, because obviously the situation was I didn't know if I could go back, when I could go back, all of those things. And actually around about that time, I made a real mindset change. And for that, I owe you, James, so many thanks for all of that amazing content and stuff you give. But the mindset change that I had was I looked at it and I think it might have even been one of your Transformation Tuesdays that you did in the group. And I looked at it and said, I can't.
Did you hear
control.
That?
No, I missed that.
Which you're now on, by the way.
Which is crazy. It's crazy. But I looked at it and I said, you know what? I can't change what's happened. I can't plan. All I can control is what I do. I can wish that I was in China. I can wish that I was still there. And on top of that as well, I then unfortunately just started going out with this with a girlfriend, and then that all went wrong because she got trapped in Russia. I got trapped here. And so I looked at it and I said, actually, do you know what? I'm gonna focus on what I can control. And what I could control was the business and running that. And I stopped trying to plan for 6 months in the head and letting my mind run away with these, you know, well, I could go back and I could do this and I could do this, because all the plans I'd made had just been completely and utterly trashed. I just said, right, I'm going to focus on the business, focus on the thing, except that I'm living back in my parents' house, except that I'm living back in England and it's not what I want, but it's there's a pandemic on, etc. And that mindset, I think, was really the key thing. And that was partly what led me to jump into the full course and just say, right, do you know what? I'm going for this.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think that one lesson for anybody who's watching this looking for golden nuggets or takeaways or lessons that they can take away from Sim and the progress that he's made in his own business, that one thing, taking control and ownership and responsibility, regardless of what the external factors are. Oh, COVID's happened, oh, I lost my job, or because you could have very easily gone down the path that I'm pretty sure 95% of people in that situation would go down, but you didn't. You went down the path that the 5% of people went down, and here you are, man. So that's testimony to you, credit to you, And that has a massive part to play with why you're now sitting here joining me on a transformation.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, I did tell you I have a surprise for you.
Yeah, you
which I haven't shared, but I also closed a $3,500 deal yesterday as well. So smashed out another 3-month deal for $3,750 on my new offer. So what that actually puts it about 10,000 and 10,000 in 7 days. And that's the best thing is that's not even in my niche. It's a completely different niche. I didn't do any demonstration, anything. I just straight sold them.
So you told me, was it about 4 weeks ago that we started that you jumped into the one-to-one? You wanted to work with me one-to-one, right?
Yeah.
And you said, I want to be hitting 10K months by Christmas. Yeah. What have you done this month?
Eight and a half. So in the last 7 days, 8.5. And I've got a really big deal coming up because I've run for one of my clients. They paid for one month for two campaigns, and we've got them 160 leads in those three days. Absolutely. So they will. I'm just waiting for them to deal with the fallout from that, so that I can then sign them to a longer term deal as well. So hopefully next week there's going to be another one.
Awesome, man. Congratulations. And thanks for keeping that as a surprise. That's a wicked surprise. dropping bombs live. Let's talk a little bit about your actual business, right? Because
absolutely.
Especially for anybody who's potentially watching this, who, you know, isn't part of the lifestyle marketeer, doesn't work with us and is perhaps watching this going, okay, so you made 6K in a day and you know, 8.5K in it's actually
it's nearly $10K dollars because it's
in dollars. Yeah, exactly. So let's talk about how, right? So in your business, who are you? Who do you help and what do you help them do? So tell us a little bit about your business.
Yes. Yeah, so I work with fitness businesses. So PTs, gyms, typically PTs, but I do also work with gyms and health clubs and that sort of thing. And I help turn them from burnt out, tired PTs who are walking the gym floor, hitting, you know, approaching every Tom, Dick and Harry in the gym, trying to kind of make a sale, basically into confident PTs who are not trading time for money, but are closing 3-month packages, getting in leads and have a client attraction system that's then generating them leads, even if they're not running ads.
How long have you been working with that market for?
So I picked that market just probably before I joined the full course because I'd done a couple of weeks in the market. So about 4 months, 4.5 months, but with a tied down offer, 3-4 weeks.
Yeah, got it. But you've only been in the program for about 3 months. So,
yeah, that's right. Yeah.
So if it was just before that, so it was maybe a month or so before you actually decided to work with us, like, you know, more closely, right? That's awesome, man. So, what you've just said is cool, but like, can you break it down very simply for anybody who's not familiar with the business model? Yeah. How do you help them do those things? What exactly do you help them do in their business?
So I help them work out who they are. I help them with first stage is helping them with some market research because you wouldn't believe how shocking PTs are at market research. And actually helping them with even sort of thinking about themselves as a business because so many just don't think of themselves as business. So helping them with that's quite a big step. And once we kind of know who we're targeting and who resonates with their thing, we then put out an offer to those people and I build an offer for them and I build the Facebook ad mechanism for them. Also whilst giving them lots of free stuff on, you know, LinkedIn and other things like that, other useful bits. And then I help them also with then the sales side of things. So actually talking to potential prospects and having those conversations and how they should be having those conversations and that sort of thing.
It almost breaks down into a 3-step process, which I think is massive for people who are perhaps watching this, who are trying to get their offer and their pitch and their basically landing more clients. This is huge. Break it down in your 3-step process, Sim.
So the first step is the offer. The first step is the offer for my clients.
Yeah.
So that's helping them work out exactly who they should be talking to, why they're, and more importantly, why they're talking to that people. Because so many PTs say, oh, well, I talk to busy professionals. So you say, well, why are you talking to busy professionals? And you go, okay, right. So there's no point talking to somebody if you don't know why you're talking to them and why they're going to listen to you. So helping get that understanding over is quite important. The second step is then actually getting the leads. So, and I tie marketing message into this as well. So talking about what they're actually, the content they're actually putting out there, whether that be through Facebook ads or through their Facebook profile or LinkedIn or whatever, getting that a common stream of a message through everything they put out there and everything they brand and everything they say that helps drive people towards them and helps people have that conversation with them. And then the third step is sales, is actually then closing that which I'm getting better at, clearly. So then imparting some of that sales wisdom that I have onto them and helping them to close more people and say, well, look, this is actually, you're going wrong here, or you're not handling that objection very well, or that sort of thing.
Awesome. Can you explain to me then why somebody would pay you $3,500 just referring to the last deal that holds about $3,750? Is that pounds?
Yeah.
So we're flicking between currencies. Let's roll with it. So £3,750 is the last deal that you closed for a personal training client, right? That you're going to be working with to help do those things, attract more customers, grow their business. How does it look to them?
Well, it's a complete overhaul because.
Let me rephrase that. What happens when they pay you £3,750, right, for a 3-month service? What are you going to be like? Why would they pay you £3,750? We just touched on how it looks. So sorry about that.
Because without me, they haven't got a clue. They're trying to. So many people are trying to build a house without getting the foundations in place properly. So what I'm doing is I'm looking at it a bit like a house surveyor. I come in and I look and say, you know, you've got a problem there. You've got a structural problem there. You've got a structural problem there. And these are the fixes. And quite often they're not even things that they've even thought about as an issue. So even as a real simple example, I spoke to them, the guy I spoke to yesterday, and he said, oh, I said, have you run lead generation before? He said, yeah, I've paid someone to run it before. And we got loads of leads through. And some people didn't even know who we were when we phoned them. And I said, well, did you send them a text message and an email saying that, you know, thanks for giving us your details? No. What do you mean? So what? If you phone them 3 days later, how are they going to know? Of course, they're not going to know who you are. Whereas if you send them a text message saying, here we are, thanks for sending your details, this is who, you know, someone will be in touch, then you get that thing. So the reason people pay me the money they pay me is because I uncover some of those real issues that they clearly are just not noticing and perhaps don't even know about.
Yeah, because you've like, as you said earlier, you've only actually been doing this for like 3 or 4 months, right? And like, forgive me for saying this, Sim, but like, you're a young guy. Like, how old are you?
I'm 25 now.
25. So how the hell is a 25-year-old who's been doing this for 3 or 4 months able to charge somebody £3,750 for a 3-month service and transform their business? Like, how?
I have a good mentor.
Who is he?
Yeah, you might know him. So how is because actually it's all about how you position it and how you talk to somebody. And if you position yourself as an expert and you position yourself as a someone who knows what they're talking about, then it becomes much easier to convince somebody else to pay you that kind of money. And the proof is very much in the pudding of sort of some of the things I've done. So I can say, yes, I can fall back on a bank of examples of how I've got this company, this many leads, this company. But to be honest, in strategy sessions, I don't even really touch upon that anymore because it's just not needed. Because actually, if you have a conversation and you just on the call, you actually analyze with them what their problems are and they can see that you're already adding value to them, then it's a no-brainer for them because they go,
That's pretty cool, man. Like, how do you want to just finish off what you were going to say before?
Yeah, so on the call, I'll take them through the the process, and I'll take them through the process of what they're already doing, because invariably I've had a conversation with them before where they've said, oh, well, you know, this is a problem, or I have an issue with this. And you say, so I take them through the issue that they're having and say, this is how I would fix it, but not this is how you should fix it. This is how I would fix it. And therefore they need me to fix it.
Got it. So like people get caught up in the money, right? They're like, oh my God, you landed. Was it that day? Was it last week where you landed a couple of clients? Was it two clients that paid up that?
Yeah, it was two clients. Okay. One paid up, so it was £4,800 total, and it was then 3,000 of that paid up front. But that wasn't even actually in a day. It was between 5 o'clock and 8 o'clock.
Yeah,
so it was about 3 hours.
So like people get caught up in the money, right? And they're like, I want to start a business, I want to make money, I want to get rich, I want to blah 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 blah, and that's cool. That's obviously, you know, that's what drives most people who want to start a business, well, everyone really. So why, like, let's talk a little bit about the other side of that and the actual service value that you're delivering to your clients. Tell us about the best, bearing in mind you've been doing this 3 or 4 months.
Yeah.
Tell us about the best campaign that you've run for one of your clients and what that meant to their business.
So this actually is, it ties in for a bit of a longer thing, because there's kind of been two or three examples of this. So I work with a walking group, right, called, I won't get to their names, but they, I took one of them on as a client, but they basically, they're a walking community, that operates a bit like an outdoor health club. And in the first month, we got 60 leads or something through for this client. And he was totally and utterly, you know, like over the moon with it. The second month we upped that to 85 by running a different campaign. And he had then put me in touch with his franchise bosses. He's a franchisee. He put me in touch with his bosses, and he then spoke to me, and actually this guy's the guy, one of the guys I closed to a 3 month deal last week. So he then sort of put me up to his bosses, and his bosses sort of said, well, look, we'll take a punt on you, show us what you can do, you know, let's have a look. And so I ran two campaigns for them simultaneously, and as I said, as we closed it down yesterday, and they're hoping to reopen it next week, but we closed it down yesterday, and it was at 93 leads. I put it on the group actually, but it was at 93 leads for one campaign and 81 for the other, off 150 180 ad spend.
£150, £108 ad spend,
yeah.
to get you know,
90 leads.
Yeah,
and these are new launches. What's really exciting about this is these are new launches of their business in new areas. So this is right from the beginning of their business. That's 100, you know, nearly 100 new clients potentially coming through with a value of 30 grand for that business.
Yeah,
So it's huge for that business. Huge for that business. And having a group of people who are, you know, who they've been running in the health and fitness industry for 30, 40 years, doing sales, doing this, running health clubs, all the rest. And having them on a call going, we're just blown away. We weren't expecting, you know, the fact you've done it in three different areas with three different campaigns just shows you know your stuff. And we just, so now I've got to tie them to a 3 month contract.
good man. Cool, let's talk about lessons, right? Because obviously you know, you said it's been an interesting 3 months when I first asked you at the beginning. It's not always plain sailing, is it? It comes with its issues, comes with its challenges. Let's talk about those, right? So what would you share with those people who are watching now, who are like now watching this and going, oh my god, Sim's only been here 3 months and you know he's already close to smashing five-figure months. What advice and guidance would you give those people? Here and now?
The three big lessons I've learned is, one, follow the training. Because the training has answered an awful lot of the questions. And Lara and Charlotte have been fantastic in answering, and yourself as well, have been fantastic in answering some of the other questions that I've then had and encountering problems. Second thing is ask. Just, you know, when you first said to me, or I first heard you say, you know, the only question, the only stupid question is one you don't ask. And I thought, oh, that's a bit cheesy. That's a bit cool, you know. But actually, it's so true. It's so true that actually there's been even times after I've jumped on the one-to-one with you and you've just kind of gone on Voxer, why have you been sitting on that for 2 days? Why didn't you just ask me? And the example yesterday, so yesterday I sent James a message saying, just before I had a call with my franchise guys, and I sent him a message saying, James, I don't know what I've done, but I've lost all the results. All the results have disappeared on Ads Manager. And it was reading like 93 and 81, and I now can't see them. What have I done? Is it a glitch with Facebook? Do I need to worry? James was just like, have you checked the dates are right? Because you've probably just put in the wrong dates. And lo and behold, I've put in the wrong dates. Now, I could have sat there and waited, and the old me probably would have sat there and panicked about that for 2 or 3 days. I'd actually just messaged you, and you just, yeah. And we had a good laugh about it, and off it went.
To be fair, that only comes from the experience of helping, coaching, and mentoring, you know, 700 people who are a similar, complete startup business. Yeah. So I just want to touch on something, because we've been working together one to one right now for roughly about 4 weeks, right? So whereabouts were you at? Because you still had some clients and you were making progress, but like whereabouts were you at 4 weeks ago? And why did you decide to, after 2 months of being in the Lifestyle Marketeer, decide to work with me one to one?
So first month I invoiced, I think, 1,500. The second month I then invoiced 2,200. And then obviously this month I've invoiced 8,000. So when I invoiced 2000, it came up that the one-to-one was there. I'd been aware of it. But to be honest, I'd seen how much of a difference jumping into the full program made to me from jumping from the Kickstarter, that it just made sense to jump up again higher. And it was a real gamble, because I literally gambled the £1,000 I had from the client sale coming in. On banking that if I worked with you, I'd be able to make another £1,000 the following, you know, or whatever it was. And
what have you done again?
And then I've done $8,500.
So good decision.
It was definitely a good decision, and has just even more so than I actually thought, because I knew it would help. And there was a live you did a while ago on the importance of just making decisions and backing the decisions you make. And so I umdenard for about half a day. And then I thought, actually, do you know what? Just if you're going to do this in 4 months' time, do it now. But, you know, why wait? If it's going to help me. And it was a question you said, is it going to help you get, is working with me one-to-one going to help you get to that 10 grand a month? The answer is obviously yes. So there we are.
Massive, man. You're literally the epitome of the word backing yourself, right? Making decisions, backing your decisions by action. But you know, coachability level 10 out of 10, man. So I can't take anything away from you on that front. Cool. So we've touched on that. That's great. You've got such a wicked story that we could literally sit here and talk all day. But go on, man.
I was just going to say the other bit that I haven't actually mentioned, which kind of ties in very nicely with my story, is that I first spoke to you guys back in about a year ago at this point, when I saw an ad as I was looking to move jobs, and I knew I didn't want to do teaching. My school was a nightmare. I started in the January, the school didn't open. I didn't do any teaching till September. And I knew I didn't want to be there. I knew I didn't want to do it. So I kind of said I would do one more year and then I would find something else. And I obviously came across you guys. And I had a call. I can't remember who I had a call with. It was either Bradley or Benjamin. And basically it got down to the fact that I couldn't get the money out of China. can actually physically move the money I had in out of China. And I'd kind of gone to do it. I'd kind of decided to do it. And then very sadly, my grandmother actually passed. And I then used that money to fly back for her funeral, having missed my grandfather's funeral because he died 3 days after I landed in China. And I didn't have the relevant documents sorted to go back. So suddenly that whole kind of plan again had just fallen apart. And then the Kickstarter turned up about 3 weeks later, 4 weeks later. And I immediately, I think I was probably the first person when that video came up. I didn't actually even watch the video where you announced it. I just clicked the link and signed up. And then I'd
something we know a lot of do now, by the way, in case anybody.
We don't do it anymore. But it then very neatly came back full circle because actually, obviously, during the whilst I was back during the COVID pandemic, my parents' inheritance came through, and they actually gave me and my siblings some money from our grandparents, and I then used my money to join the full course.
Got it, man. So, what, like, looking back now, or to anybody who's in a similar situation, who is trying to decide whether or not, you know, that one, me and the Lifestyle Marketeer program is one, legit, two, high quality, and obviously three, life changing, evidently. What would you say to those people who are on the fence, who are like, oh, I might do it, might not, might keep teaching? What would you say to them?
I would say, from my perspective, if it wasn't for James and it wasn't for the Lifestyle Marketeer and the community and the thing, I don't think I'd have made it through this year in the way that I have. Because the forgetting the money, forgetting the business, forgetting all of those things, actually the mindset help and support that I've been given and the way I look at the world now, it's completely different to how I looked at it 4 months ago and completely different to how I looked at it 7 months ago. And some of those challenges, I just jump over challenges now that would have derailed me before. So if you are sitting on the fence, I mean, if you're considering whether or not it's legit, it is. It absolutely is. If you're considering whether or not it's going to be good for you, I cannot stress enough how much it's going to be good for you. And how much it goes above and beyond what I thought it went, what I thought it did. You know, I thought it was about how to build a marketing business, and yet it's all gives you all the mindset stuff on how to build a business. And that is just, it's huge. It's so much bigger than you think.
And the mindset, obviously, one week of the training that we have.
Exactly.
Like fundamentally one massive thing that I think's had a huge impact on you. I just want to be clear for anybody who's listening to that and going, oh, well, is it just a mindset?
No.
The 9 week training is focused on
completely and utterly, a guide to building a business. And me, who's always wanted to run my own business and always known I'm going to run my own business, this is just taken me from A to B a million times faster than I ever could have done it. And good, to the point, I can't imagine not having done it now. And yeah,
there you are, starring and featuring in our Transformation Tuesdays, man. I'm gonna have to wrap this up because
no worries,
my pop's about to die and I'm looking at the battery like, oh my god, if it just cuts off, what will happen? Sim, you've been an absolute legend. Love having you in the TLM. Love working with you one-to-one, man. You're an absolute delight to coach. Thanks for coming on and sharing your story.
Pleasure.
I hope that actually helped anyone else who's watching this as well, either whether you don't yet work with us and you're thinking about it, or whether you do work with us and you're taking those lessons away from Sim's journey as well. Any final words, man? I've got 3% battery, so like, any final words for anybody who's watching?
Back yourself and do it. You won't regret it.
Awesome, man. In both sense. In the one-to-one sense and in the
every sense, both if you're joining TLM and if you're thinking about the one-to-one, just do it because it's life-changing. Cool. And any questions, I'm happy to answer in the comments
wherever. Cool, Sim, thank you so much for your time.
Pleasure. Keep James,
get that victory post in the group now. You kept
I will do.
Cool, man, well done, peace out, keep smashing it.
Cheers.
Thanks for watching, everyone. Bye-bye. See you soon.